pattern. That's why the influx of guns and drugs so high in Trinidad. And he's saying, guess what? Basically, they control this region. They control this region. And what the times a person here is going to get worse. The thing's going to get worse. The crime is going to get worse. You understand? There are plenty of unanswered questions within our, within certain things passing through our shores. Why is it unanswered? Because basically it's part of what went on across there. Right? That this Jacob's trouble is on us. Right? But these people not listening. These people not getting themselves right. So guess what? That is them not dancing. That is them making these scriptures be manifest. Finish it off, finish it off, Lamar.
Yeah. Let's say something real quick. Another thing they say, right now, as I said, we want any plug, we just jump on memory. They say right now, we have a high influx of Venezuelan plucking in Colombia. Colombia, economy already in shit. Plenty of them Colombians coming here. So imagine when the Venezuelans go to Colombia. We're going to have money, going to cause Colombia to crash even more.
Alone in their system.
And then after they leave from Colombia, where's they going to come? They're going to come to the next best place. Yeah. It's just like rats. What rats used to do when they get cut out? They seek dry land.
They put the rat on the coach, man. Yeah. Put the bucket. And they light the bucket on fire. And what are you going to do? You're either eat through steel, or you go eat through the flesh. Because the flesh is easier at the time. But when the time comes, and the pressure thing, they will dig through that steel. You understand? The same thing. So they go to Colombia for it easier, because they just crossing
right
our borders.
Yes, right.
But that's all they're already crossing seas. They had to cross a sea to come to us. Right?
They give me 7 miles in city. 7 miles, that's right
here. Hey, they have niggas that will swim now.
Yes, sir. Hey, on that pressure, people will swim now.
Look what's going on with the refugee crisis from Syria, the refugee delivery from Syria. Some of them are leaving from the capital state. That comes to what? Europe. You understand? You're under pressure.
Well, this is 2 Kings 15:16. For there shall be sedition among men and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power.
Hey, the scripture says wisdom and knowledge shall be the same ability at that time. Right? So we're not going to fear, we're not going to tremble, we're going to wait to be guided by the spirit of Yahweh Shemeshai. Right? But guess what? They're gonna run. The whole planet is gonna be underneath the curses. The whole planet is gonna be underneath the judgment and preparation for the Lord. Right? Because all what you know, all this ability and security that you know now, is not gonna exist in the time of the Lord, in the time of his return. All this is gonna be teared up.
No. America, especially Esau talking about basically that they want to leave more refugees. But I was watching a documentary and they say basically when Esau was plucking over here during the 15th century, it is because basically they was running out of resources over there in Europe. So they was using up all the wood, the honey and fish, farming drums was shit. So you know, when they come over here, they realize how over here is, how wealthy the land is in. He's over there, the line. So they come over here, basically they come over here as refugees. You understand?
They went to they fled Europe, England, to the Americans as refugees.
But now they say, nah, when they come over the country, when they pay for these refugees or themselves.
And they're not even their country.
What's your video I say? They say, I make America white again. I was like, Edomite, and he said, you mean make America white again? He said MMA, I like MMA. I like black people. He said NBA. I like black people, I like my black woman. I like my black woman. You understand? And basically America is a country because without is without jail, America is nothing. It's something that is nothing.
That's beautiful because Jake, we sweat on Jake's back. We sweat on blood off of Jake's back, built America. So our spirit is in there.
You ever watch Elysium? How you see Equilibrium?
Yeah, way back when, yeah. Super.
You ever notice how everybody like is just robots?
Yeah,
that is Esau without Jake.
Esau,
basically Esau without Jake.
Beautiful, they say that. What's up, Esau does cook? Jake cook. We cook. We flavor to taste. We season to taste. Esau seasons by what? By exact measurement. Take a quarter cup of this, a teaspoon of that, a third cup or a fourth cup of this. You understand? So everything always, that's why they try to create that perfection in everything that they do, right? That's why all, when they watch out, he so set shit up, right? All the pretzels gonna be perfect. You understand? All the chicken must be fried and have this texture and this glow. You understand? But we do it by spirit.
So, now I expect you to say, please still let them go. Let them take two of them. Now I lay one and all then go and then shake up. I've seen that more of this through some men are labor turn Jacob. That basically like he realized that he gave blessings through Jacob.
Yeah, his increase, but he was there.
This is Matthew 5 verse 13. Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt of lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted?
Yeah, we are the salt of the earth. Who is he? The 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. We are the salt. But if we are lost its savor, how we lose our savor? By becoming the niggers or the niggards that we are, or that Jake is. But we are, because we are this lineup, we separate ourselves from the world. Right? Hey, funny enough, I should say that because what? I was talking to a tutor, a lawyer, grew up with. I was talking to him. He reached out because one of our childhood friends died in recent times. Right? And he was the one reflecting on how much of our childhood friends or neighbors died. Right? And he's saying, hey, what is their legacy? And he's going on the part of all of them, they basically fulfilled their purpose, but is ready to share. And then he reached to me, and he had a comment to make, hey, if on a Saturday night, or Monday morning, or Monday evening, you know, you could be doing all any other thing in a club, smoking weed, drinking, running hoes, or you out there preaching the word, you understand? Guess what, to me, you know what I ring off as? Hey, we are the light of the world, you understand? We are the soul, right? So, hey, even though you think that they ain't looking, but they're looking. We shining, we being the example that the scripture speak about. Exemplars, you understand? We have our integrity to keep in this world.
Jeremiah 50 verse 33 says, thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah, who oppressed together, no longer took them captives, held them fast, they refused to let them go.
Right, he still refused to let us go. We still in captive. Hey, when the Lord comes, we're still going to be in the hands of Esau. And how we know that? Because the scripture says so. And because we can see that they are proud men. They refuse to let us up. They refuse to come out right and say, hey, we as a white man, we are the devil. And you are higher than us, you are better than us, you are the Lord's chosen people. You are the nation of Israel. You are not Negroes. You are not African Americans. You are not all these other bywords. We stole you all from the land. Right? We are our allies. The Hamites, we stole you all. And we sold you all. And we profited it. We built our cities from you all. Of your blacks and slaves. And your God is the God of heaven and earth. And his name is Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. And your language is Hebrew. And your heritage is the law, statutes, and commandments. Because if they do that, guess what? It will start with the nigger woman. Because as long as the white man speaks, the nigger woman will believe. Right? As long as the nigger woman believes, she will offer up her sons to believe. And then she will put her daughters back in submission. But the white man worked at the reverse. And what has happened? We became salt. We became flavorless. The salt had lost its savor when they started to exalt their daughters and put their sons in submission. And make the sons effeminate and weak and masculine, right?
And I went to school just talk about the group until they began to seek it. They began to seek it. But if you're watching history, right? All the captivity went to when it was Israel. You understand? So basically, we still had the same at our point. But when we came here, when Esau did, outside Judah, God, the heritage out of us. House of Israel, it will be the same thing to them. Understand? If they spoke their language, they will beat them. So they basically they Hellenize Israel coming over on this side because it could get too rough.
an extra money is used to separate the family. Like you send the father to the next plantation,
move
the children to the next plantation. So that's how they get a program you do. You know, so you grow the family so that your days are like.
Hey, that is why they send me to school from a young age to indoctrinate us, like Garama, and I send me the 25 plan of the elite.
The Benatis.
One of them basically still just indoctrinate the children with the fairy tales.
Right.
Yes, like you say, boy and father, cow jump over the moon, all that bullshit. This is Ezekiel 34, Saturn at Satan jumping up to 5. It says, my sheep wandered through all the mountains and upon every high hill. Yea, my flock was scattered upon all the face of the earth, and none did search or seek after them. And they were scattered because there is no shepherd, and they became meat to all the beasts of the field when they were scattered.
Guess what? From ever since, I have never moved to Judah. The sheep just said, the scepter shall not depart from Judah. When they examine, the time since we know of ourselves, right, Judah? Spirit has always led, right? In music, in dance, Judah's spirit always led. Whatever Judah did across in America, the tribes followed and emulate up to this day. We still have Judah as being our example, right? So the leaders of the people know is who? Jay-Z is who? Is Young Thug, you know? Kanye West, and I don't even know how to look so long. But, you know, they're Judah, right? They're the leaders of the other tribes, right? But guess what? Alright, go ahead.
Genesis 49 verse 8, it says, Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise. Thy hand shall be in the neck of thine enemies. Thy father's children shall bow down before thee.
Yeah, thy father's children shall bow down before thee. So that, hey, then you skip this about exactly the words. Right? We emulate whatever Judah do. But if of course then any seat and the so-called any bosom and the so-called white man, right? They take away and they effeminate the men. Right? They take away and effeminate the men. They took them away from the home. They leave the women to rule the home. They lock up all the males. Right? They conquer behavior of what? Of gangster and tough life. Of death, for basically that's what they like, that's what they encourage death. That's what they promote, death, MTV, BET. You understand? VH1, it's death to all race.
Because, listen this, you ever notice, it's only obvious. The people who run the country, they would actually sit down, see problems in the country, and see all the solutions to, plausible solutions to solve the problem. No, you see that it inhumane to beat a child. But then you realize, hey, like them fucking teeth of my children. They're totally out of order.
Must raise in demons.
Alright? So you would be like, hey, nah, you gotta do something, you gotta try something for no. Speak to them. Speak to what? The scripture says, speak them.
Yeah,
you send them little devils. That's why the scripture say, menstruous woman shall bring forth monsters. But that is part of the plot. Because when you had a child growing up like that now, guess what? You're gonna start to push more in the media now, because one of the agenda they say to push drugs, guns, alcohol, so basically just to break up the home. That's why the prisons, they blame more prisons. Understand? I think that is also, they don't build no hospital, all they build is a prison. Yeah. Understand? Because why? It's to take Jake and to get Jake out of their way, basically. To control Jake. That is basically to control Jay, because it's really spreading too much. The more you oppress them, the more they multiply. Like all we could do anyways. Yes, okay. Sir? Hey. Well, they're allowing me to do nothing else. Well.
This is Zephaniah chapter 2 verse 1. Gather yourself together, yea, gather together, O nation, not desire. Before the decree break forth, before the day pass as the shaft, before the face anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord anger come upon you.
Yeah, so it says before the evil times come, gather to the Lord. Don't wait until all hell break loose to see here, but you guys seek the Lord now. You guys say seek the Lord while he may be found. You understand? Seek the Lord now. Right now, that's why the prophets out here summon the trumpet.
the alarm.